Oke, untuk hari ini kita akan buat sedikit latihan. Kita bincang latihan di bahagian belakang modul. Oke, kita bincang beberapa soalan. Macam mana nak menjawab soalan tersebut? Oke. Boleh nampak slide?
Nampak sih.
Boleh, sir.
Okey, kita terus ke soalan yang pertama di belakang sekali modul. Ujian ada macam test di belakang. Okey, number one, identify whether a redox reaction occur for each reaction below. Reaction one, iron 2 sulfate FeSO4 plus magnesium Mg produce iron Fe plus magnesium sulfate MgSO4. Reaction 2, silver nitrate AgNO3 plus NaCl sodium chloride produce silver chloride AgCl and sodium nitrate NaNO3. So explain your answer based on the change in oxidation number. Okay, so untuk soalan ni awak kena identify lah adakah reaction 1 and reaction 2 itu redox reaction or not. Okay, so macam mana kita nak tahu? So soalan kata dia nak kita explain based on oxidation number. Okay, kita tengok reaction 1, FeSO4 plus Mg produce Fe plus MgSO4. Okay, iron sulfate kita tahu dia ada ion dalam tu, which is Fe2 plus ion and sulfate SO4 2-. Okay, and then Mg dia bukan ion, dia cuma atom. Okay, for magnesium sulfate is magnesium ion Mg2 plus and sulfate SO4 2-. Okay, bila kita dah buat pecahan macam ini, kita nampaklah yang mana ion, yang mana atom. Okay, now we look at the charge of ion and atom. Okay, charge yang terdapat pada ion dan atom. Okay, for ion Fe, okay, first oxidation number dia is positive 2. Okay, because the number charge is 2 positive. So oxidation number ON positive 2. Sulfate, okay, tengok nombor charge-nya 2-, so oxidation number is negative 2. Okay, magnesium ni dia atom, neutral lah, so charge-nya 0. Kalau charge dia 0, so oxidation number is 0. Okay, for the product, iron Fe, ini juga atom, so oxidation number is 0. Magnesium sulfate, Mg2 positif, oxidation number positif 2, sulfate negatif 2. Okay, so kita lihat which substance okay undergoes oxidation and reduction. Kita tengok iron Fe, oxidation number dia change from positif 2 into 0. Daripada positif 2 dia menjadi kosong. Ini increase or decrease?
Decrease
oxidation number. Okay, sulfate kita lihat ada perubahan tak?
Tidak.
So dia tak ada mengalami oxidation atau reduction. And then kita lihat magnesium. Oxidation number 0 becomes positive 2. Ini increase oxidation number. Okay. So kalau masih ingat, first kali kita belajar redox. Okay. Kalau decrease oxidation number, this one is oxidation or reduction.
Reduction.
Reduction. Kalau increase oxidation number, dia ialah
oxidation.
So kalau ada berlaku reduction and oxidation, maksudnya reaction one is a redox reaction. Okay, then I will explain lah based on the change in oxidation number. Okay, saya padam ni. Okay, ini jawapan dia lah, penerangan. Okay, reaction 1 is a redox reaction. The oxidation number of iron decreases from positive 2 to 0. So iron undergoes reduction. The oxidation number of magnesium increases from 0 to positive 2. Magnesium undergoes oxidation. So bila ada reduction dengan oxidation, maksudnya the overall reaction is redox. Okay, how about reaction 2? Kita tengok. Silver nitrate. Okay, apa ion dalam ni? Silver Ag plus, nitrate NO3 negative. Sodium chloride. Sodium Na positive, chloride Cl negative. Then the product silver chloride. Dia masih lagi ion ah. Sodium nitrate. Na positive, NO3 negative. Okay, so kita lihat oxidation number dia. Okay, ada perubahan tak? Silver. Awak tengok silver.
Silver
reaction dengan produk dia masih sama, positive 1. Begitu juga dengan nitrate. Okay, sodium sama, chloride pun sama. So dia tak ada change in oxidation number, maksudnya tidak ada berlaku oxidation ataupun reduction. So reaction 2 is not a redox reaction. Reason dia no change in oxidation number. Okay, so ini cara kita nak menjawab bagi soalan seperti inilah. Okay, nanti awak boleh screenshot dan salin dalam modul. Okay, question 2. The overall ionic equation below shows the reaction between iodine I2 and sulfur dioxide SO2. Okay, tindak balas antara iodine dengan sulfur dioxide. So, based on the equation above, state the change in oxidation number for iodine and sulfur. Name the oxidizing agent and reducing agent in this reaction. Write the reduction half equation. Okay. So, kita tengok. Dia sekarang minta tentang iodine and sulfur. Okay, kita tengok iodine dulu. I2. Okay. This one is molecule. Ada charge tak di sini?
Zero.
Zero kan? So, oxidation number dia, ON is 0 untuk iodine. Okay. Bila dia dekat produk, okay, negative. Okay. I negative. So, oxidation number is
negative
1. So, ini increase or decrease ni?
Decrease.
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 Reduction.
Oxidation number. So ini reduction. Okay. And then kita tengok untuk sulfur. Sulfur ni dia ada ni sikit lah. Awak perlu buat pengiraan. Sulfur, dia bukan, dia dalam bentuk sulfur dioxide. Okay. Sulfur dioxide is a molecule. Okay. So the total charge is zero untuk sulfur dioxide. Sekarang kita kena tahu what is the oxidation number of sulfur sahaja. Okay. So ini kita pernah belajar dahulu. Okay. Kita nak cari sulfur, kita buat dia sebagai X. Okay. Plus, okay. Oksigen O2, dia ada 2 oksigen. Okay. Oksigen, oxidation number of oxygen. Okay. Kalau dia dalam bentuk compound, okay. Oxidation number dia is negative 2. Awak boleh refer balik yang kita dah belajar di awal-awal dulu. Okay, tentang oxidation number. Okay. So bila kita jumlahkan, overall oxidation number should be zero lah. Okay, charge sulfur dioxide ni zero. So oxidation number is zero. So X minus 4, zero. X is positive 4. Jadi sulfur dalam sulfur dioxide ni is positive 4. Saya tulis di bawah. Okay, ini dekat sulfur dioxide. Dekat produk, sulfate ion. Ini juga kita kena kira. Okay. Sulfate ion ini, overall charge-nya is 2 negative. Okay, maksudnya, overall oxidation number is negative 2. So, kita kena cari sekarang untuk sulfur sahaja dalam sulfate ion ini ada berapa. Masih kena kira lagi. X plus, okay, oksigen ada 4, 4 multiply. Oxidation number for oxygen is negative 2. Okay. So total dia haruslah negative 2. X minus 8 negative 2. X equal to positive 6. Okay, so dekat produk, sulfur is positive 6. So kita lihat oxidation number increase. So ini oxidation. Okay, so kita boleh jawab soalan A. State the change in oxidation number for iodine and sulfur. Okay. Dapat nampak oxidation number of iodine is from 0 to negative 1. Okay. Oxidation number of sulfur positive 4 to positive 6. Okay, and then question B, name the oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So, bila kita dah tahu which one undergoes oxidation dengan reduction, kita tahulah yang mana merupakan oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So, oxidizing agent is iodine because oxidation number dia tadi decrease. Dia mengalami reduction. So, dia adalah oxidizing agent. Sulfur, oxidation number increase. So, dia mengalami oxidation. Dan oxidation, bahannya ialah reducing agent. Okay, sulfur. Write the reduction half equation. Okay. Reduction iodine lah. Okay, iodine accept 2 electrons form 2 iodide ion. Okay, 2i negatif. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan nak tanya untuk soalan 2 ni? Setakat ini faham?
Cikgu.
Ya.
Yang oxidation number ya. Tadi yang oksigennya negatif 2. Sini kita tangganya, cikgu.
Sini kita tangganya.
Oh.
Okey, awak rujuk balik modul, dia ada satu condition lah, okey. Oksigen kalau dia dalam bentuk compound, okey, dia ada dengan sebatian lain lah, okey. Oxidation number dia is negative 2. Lepas ni kita tengok balik awak punya modul lah. Kita akan buat ni balik, revision balik. Okay, so kita teruskan untuk soalan seterusnya. Question 3, figure 1 shows the setup apparatus and observation for the experiment to study displacement of metal from its salt solution. Okay, experiment ni kita belum buat dalam chapter 9 ni lah, tapi kita pernah buat dalam heat of displacement, chapter 12, chapter 11. Dalam bab thermochemistry kita buat, kita cari heat of displacement. Okay, so kita tengok setup of apparatus. X nitrate solution and then lead strip. Okay, lead is Pb. Observation, blue color X nitrate solution becomes pale blue. Ini maklumat ataupun clue kita yang pertama. Blue color, apa solution yang color dia warna biru?
Copper.
Copper.
Yes, okay. Copper. Copper kalau dia dalam bentuk solution ialah color biru. So ini ialah copper to nitrate. Okay, and then lead strip becomes thinner. Brown solid deposited at the bottom of the test tube. Okay, suggest a suitable X nitrate solution and name the brown solid at the bottom of the test tube. Okay, so ini tadi ialah displacement of a metal. Okay, metal kita ialah lead. Okay, Pb. Solution kita ialah copper nitrate. Okay, kalau observation dia kata blue color becomes pale blue and then lead strip becomes thinner. Maksudnya di sini lead telah displace copper from solution. Okay, yeah, so overall reaction-nya seperti ini. CuNO3 2 plus Pb, okay, becomes lead 2 nitrate plus Cu. Okay, yang blue color becomes pale blue ni disebabkan oleh copper ion dalam solution tu telah semakin berkurangan. Okay, concentration of copper ion decreases. Lead strip become thinner ni sebab lead metal dia becomes ion. Okay, dia release electron becomes lead 2 ion. Brown solid ni ialah copper lah. Copper yang telah displaced by lead. Okay, so suggest suitable X solution and name the brown solid. Okay, jawapan kita copper to nitrate. CuNO3 bracket 2. Brown solid is copper. B, write the half equation for oxidation and reduction. Okey, nah dalam tindak balas ini oxidation berlaku pada lead, okey, metal. Metal becomes metal ion. Okey, dia release electron to form lead 2 ion. Pb2 positif. Dia donate electron ah. Reduction berlaku pada copper ion. Cu2 positif, okay, accept electron to form copper atom. Okay, ionic equation, ni kita gabungkanlah half equation of oxidation and reduction. Kita punya reactant is lead, okay, plus copper ion, okay, product lead 2 ion, Pb2 positive and copper metal. Electron tak perlu kita letakkan. State the change in oxidation number of X in this experiment. Okay, so kita refer pada half equation tadilah. Cu2 positive. Cu2 positif itu ialah positif 2. Okay, untuk copper. Product dia is copper saja, which is an atom. Charge-nya 0, so oxidation number 0. Change in oxidation number positif 2 to 0. Okay, ada soalan? Ada bahagian yang kurang kurang kepastian ataupun kurang faham.
Cik Daigo.
Tak ada, okay. So, awak kena ni lah. Kena ingat banyak benda. Oxidation ni melibatkan dia release electron ataupun loss of hydrogen, ataupun dia gain oxygen, ataupun oxidation number increase. Reduction, dia melibatkan loss of oxygen, okay, gain electron, gain hydrogen, reduce oxidation number. So, kita kena kaitkan dengan itu. Okay, question 5. Okay, based on the E-naught value, arrange the following atom or ion in an ascending order of the strength of oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Okay, given in the question is the standard electrode potential of three metal, okay. Okay, and the E-naught value. Tapi cuma di sini saya rasa ada berlaku kesilapan sedikit lah. Okay, sepatutnya ini ditulis dalam bentuk apa? Reduction lah. Okay, dia perlu ditulis seperti ini. Kalau awak refer pada standard electrode potential series tu, okay, semua half equation dia ditulis dalam bentuk plus electron, dalam bentuk menerima electron. Sepatutnya ditulis begitu. Okay, dia sepatutnya ditulis macam ni lah. Okay. Sebab apa? Kalau macam ni, baru kita tahu. Sebab dalam standard electrode potential tu, dia dah bagi tahu yang di sebelah kanan, okay, right side, This one is reducing agent. Okay. On the left side, this one is oxidizing agent. Okay. So, kalau kena ingat baliklah. Okay. Apa dia reducing agent dengan oxidizing agent. Okay. Untuk reducing agent, okay, di sebelah reducing agent ini, kalau the anode value becomes more negative, dia is stronger reducing agent. Okay, semakin negatif nilai anode-nya, dia semakin stronger reducing agent. Untuk oxidizing agent pula, dia kalau semakin positif, more positive, okay, stronger oxidizing agent. Okay, so untuk susunan, the based on inner value, arrange the following atom or ion in ascending order. Susunan menaik ah. The strength of oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So jawapannya seperti inilah. Increasing strength of oxidizing agent. Okay. Dia ialah. Ni ada terbalik sikit. Betul lah. Oxidizing agent. Okay, ada terbalik sikit sini. Dia sepatutnya P2 positif, Q3 positif, R2 positif. Okay, reducing agent, R, Q, P. Ya. Awak tengok bahagian reducing ni. Makin negatif, dia semakin kuat. So, kita buat dari bawah ke atas. Okay, boleh ha? Okay, nombor 4 ni saya skip dulu. Halogen ni. Okay, question 6 ni. Okay, figure 2 shows a setup of apparatus for Voltaic cell with reference to half cell standard electrode potential anode. Identify the negative and positive terminals. Write the cell notation for the chemical cell. Write the equation for reduction, oxidation and the overall ionic equation. Calculate the voltage of the cell. Okay, so kita tengok figure 2 di sini. Dia ada two half cell. Okay, the first half cell involve tin, okay, ataupun SN, stannum. The another half cell, okay, melibatkan chlorine. Okay, digabungkan dia menjadi satu Voltaic cell. Okay. So the question now, identify the negative and positive terminal. So kita kena cari dulu, okay, standard electrode potential and anode value dia. Okay, for stannum, this one, and chlorine. Ah, kita susun from negative di atas, positif di bawah. Okay. So first kita kena lihat di bahagian reducing agent. Nah, ini bahagian reducing agent. Okay. Tadi dah diterangkan slide sebelum ni tadi. Kalau reducing agent, okay, kita kena tengok which one is stronger reducing agent. Macam mana nak tahu stronger reducing agent? we look at the enot value. Yang lebih negatif is stronger reducing agent. So dalam dalam dua ni, SN dengan CL negatif, which one is stronger reducing agent?
SN.
SN. So, kalau SN stronger reducing agent, SN will undergo oxidation or reduction?
Oxidation.
Oxidation. So, kalau oxidation, this one will become negative or positive?
Positive.
Negative. Okay.
Ingat lah, donate ini, electron ke?
Yeah, donate electron is negative. Negative terminal.
Dari negatif ke positif lah, sir.
Yeah. Okay, ingat lah, ini chemical cell ataupun Voltaic cell, anod dia negatif. Okay. Bila dia release electron, dia terminal negatif. Okay, anod. Okay. And then tengok pula untuk bahagian oxidizing agent mestilah nilai yang lebih positif. So between SN2 positif dengan chlorine Cl2, okay, more positive is chlorine. So yang akan jadi positif terminal is di sini. Ataupun ketot. So menjawab soalan A, identify the negative and positive terminal. Negative terminal is tin electrode ataupun SN. Kita mesti refer pada electrode yang digunakan lah. Okay. Untuk positive terminal, platinum. Okay, sebab dekat sini dia melibatkan gas, chlorine gas. Okay. So kita tak ada elektrod chlorine. Kita gunakan platinum S and electrod. Okay. Tapi dia berlaku ni lah. Berlaku reduction di situ. And then write the cell notation for the chemical cell. Okay. Kita mesti tulis from anod dulu ataupun negatif, barulah tulis bahagian ketot ataupun positif. Okay. Electrode, sternum ataupun tin. Okay. And then ion. Okay. Ion yang terdapat dalam solution, which is SN2 positif, aqueous 1.0 mol dm cube. Okay, and then garisan di tengah-tengah. Chloride ion, aqueous 1.0 mol. Okay, and then electrode platinum. Okay, PT. Write the equation for reduction, oxidation and overall ionic equation. Okay, untuk oxidation, SN becomes SN2 positive plus 2 electron. Reduction half equation, 2 Cl negative, okay, becomes Cl2 plus 2 electron. Silap ni. Reduction yang ini. Okay, yang ini silap. Cl2 plus 2E produce 2 Cl negative. Okay, ingat reduction dia mesti dalam bentuk accept elektron lah. Dia menerima elektron pada reaktan tersebut menerima elektron. So untuk overall ionic equation kita gabungkan reaktan SN SN okay plus chlorine gas produce SN2 positive plus 2Cl negative. And then the last question, calculate the voltage of the cell. Okay, ini pun kita dah belajar. E not E cell, okay, equal to E not value of cathode, okay, positive 1.36 minus E not value for anode, okay, negative 0.14. Okay, so kita dapat jawapan positif 1.50 volt. Okay, ada soalan kah nak tanya? Okay, ni soalan terakhir untuk kita discuss pada hari ini. 3.3 shows two sets of apparatus used to study the electrolysis of copper to nitrate solution. Okay, awak tengok figure 3 di sini. We have two set of electrolysis, set 1, set 2. Okay, both electrolysis use copper to nitrate solution. Okay, apa yang berbeza ialah type of electrode use. Okay, so question 7a, name the product formed at the anode in set 1. Okay, this is electrolysis cell. Okay, this is positive terminal and negative terminal of battery. So the electrode connected to positive is anode. Yang sambung dengan negatif is cathode. Okay, so kalau anode dia positif, okay, mestilah ion that will be discharged is negative ion. Negative ion ada dua, hydroxide from solution, okay, aqueous solution, and nitrate NO3 negative. Okay, so which ion will be discharged to form product? Explain your answer. Okay, jawapannya ialah hydroxide. Macam mana nak explain?
Inert value.
Yes, okay. We use the first factor, inert value. So kita kena refer pada inert value lah. Okay, between hydroxide, okay, and nitrate. Okay, so the product name is oxygen gas. Inert value of hydroxide ion is less positive than nitrate ion. Hydroxide is a stronger reducing agent. Hydroxide ion undergoes oxidation, okay, release electrons. Okay, this is the half equation. Okay. B, describe in brief the chemical test to verify the product at the anode in cell 1. Nah, produk dia tadi oksigen gas. Nah, macam mana kita nak buat chemical test untuk oksigen gas? Okay, kita guna glowing wooden splinter. Put a glowing wooden splinter into a test tube filled with oxygen gas. Glowing wooden splinter, rekindle ataupun relight. Okay, dia akan menyala semula. Glowing tu bara saja, kayu uji berbara. Okay, C, compare the color of copper to nitrate solution in set 1 and set 2 after the electrolysis is conducted for 1 hour. Explain your answer. Okay, soalan ni pun kita pernah bincang semasa kita belajar bahagian electrolysis ni. Okay, the color of copper to nitrate solution in set 1 becomes paler. Dia menjadi semakin pudar. Pale blue. Okay, copper ion discharge at cathode. Okay, di bahagian cathode ini, copper ion will discharge menjadi copper atom. Nanti dekat anode, karbon tu ada brown layer. Okay, brown metal deposited. Itu ialah copper atom. Okay, so bila copper ion discharge, the concentration of copper ion in the solution decrease. Okay, untuk set 2, the color of copper to nitrate in set 2 remains the same. Dia masih sama. Because the rate of copper atom ionized to form copper to ion is equal to the rate of discharge of copper ion to form copper atom. Okay, awak kena tengok type of electrode di sini. Ini anode, positive anode. Dia guna copper atom, which is an active electrode. Okay, maksudnya copper atom will becomes ion. Okay, dia akan menjadi ion. Daripada atom Cu, dia jadi ion Cu2+. Dekat cathode, negative terminal, dia akan discharge semula into copper. Nanti dekat cathode ni, copper becomes thicker, semakin tebal. Okay, so that's why the rate of copper atom ionized is equal to the rate of copper ion discharge at cathode. Jadi concentration of copper in solution remains the same. Kita pernah bincang ni dalam masa kita belajar electrolysis. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan lagi? Okay, tak faham C, hub. Yang mana tak faham hub? Yang set 1 ataupun set 2? Set 2, okay. Saya ulang semula. Okey, dalam set 2 ini, awak tengok ah, electrode that is used is copper. Okey, copper metal. Dalam electrolysis ah, kalau okey, the anode used is an active metal, copper ni kita panggil active metal. Okay, ataupun active anode sebab dia disambung kepada positive terminal of battery. Okay. Hak, awak kena tengok factor number 3 dalam electrolysis. Kalau electrode used at the anode is active electrode, for example copper, okay, that metal will become ion. Okay, atom pada metal tersebut dia akan menjadi ion. Okay, copper becomes copper ion. Okay, nanti anode ini dia akan semakin nipis, becomes thinner, because atom dah jadi ion, nah, dah masuk dalam solution ni, jadi copper to ion. Nah, itu berlaku dekat anode. And then at cathode, copper ion will be discharged. Okay, dia akan dinyahcas pada cathode menjadi atom semula. Cu2 plus becomes Cu. Okay, dia discharged by receiving electron. Ini dekat anode, ini dekat cathode. Okay, anode dia hasilkan copper ion. Okay, dekat cathode, copper ion yang dihasilkan tadi digunakan semula untuk menghasilkan copper. So, maksudnya tidak ada perubahan concentration of copper to ion lah dalam solution tersebut. Dia masih sama. Tak lebih, tak kurang. Okey, dah faham. Ada lain? Soalan lain lagi? Okey, mungkin nak boleh tanya dalam Telegram lah kalau ada soalan berbangkit. Ada beberapa soalan lagi. Okey, nanti kita bincang lah. Tunggu kita dah buat eksperimen, bila dah kembali ke sekolah, kita akan sambung semula perbincangan. Okay, so saya rasa kita boleh stop di sini dulu. Ada apa-apa soalan nanti boleh tanya dalam grup. Okay, itu saja daripada saya untuk hari ini. Okay, minta maaf kalau ada sebarang kekurangan. Sekian, terima kasih semua. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.